Steve, well done. 1-0 win, clean sheet. You must be over the moon with that at the halfway point of the tie.
Well, pleased with the effort tonight. You know, we knew what the game would be. We felt it would go a certain way. And you have to, you know, away from home, we have to stand up. You have to respect it and stand up to it. And obviously, we got a real good moment of excellence with Andre's goal. And yeah, you know, we managed to continue being a strong unit defensively. Could have showed a bit more quality on the ball at times, but I get it. You know, fans being back in, it was a really good atmosphere here. You know, Barnsley are a real tough team to play against in the way that they play. And there's that psychological thing of trying to protect the lead a little bit. And in the end, for the 90 minutes, we did that. But as you know, Mitch, we've been here before. You know, this time last year, you know, it's only a small lead if you manage it and protect it, and that's got to be the focus and the mentality now going into Saturday.
Just on that winning goal as well, Andre didn't have much of an impact in the game in the first half in terms of chances, but he produces when it matters, and that's what that quality brings you, doesn't it?
Yeah, well, you know, there wasn't loads of chances in the whole game, really. I mean, you know, set plays of both teams, you know, are always going to be a threat. You know, there was a couple of shots from the edge of the box. Jamal got in a good position. You know, Freddie, I think he made a good save at the end. I haven't seen it back off their corner, and a bit of a double save early on. But yeah, you know, Andre, you know, was the one that sort of made the difference on the night. So, you know we can do that, Mitch. You know, you've seen it as much as me, mate. You know, once he gets into them areas and he gets on his left foot, he can be a real handful, and he proved that tonight.
And a couple of changes from the team you started with at Watford. Some bold calls with Kyle Norton and Ben Cabango coming in, but they were excellent tonight, as were many others at the back. How pleased were you with them?
Well, the players have played a lot of games. I'm not sure why they'd be bold. But you know, yeah, I mean, for Mark and Benny, two 20-year-olds, at the back, you know, in a game like that, I thought they were excellent, and they got a great role model in Ryan Bennett and how he speaks to them and you know, talks through his experiences as well. But they did really well, and you know, just a good effort from the boys. You know, it was not a typical Swansea game, but that's fine. You know, you have to respect that. And a lot of stop starts, you know, but balls going out of play, they're going to come in your box. You know, we have to deal with it. And for tonight, we did, but it means nothing if we don't take it into Saturday.
You sampled having fans here tonight. How much you
Yeah. Yeah, fair play to Barnsley. You know, they did well tonight with the supporters, but the only thing in my mind is what the Liberty will be like on Saturday, you know, because it's really whetted the appetite, and to think that we're going to be going home. And a spare thought for the guys who won't be there as well, you know, and I've said that before, but the ones who will, you know, it's going to be a special, special moment. And obviously, you know, the big picture is about trying to get through the tie. But you know, was it 18 months or something away from supporters? It felt normal tonight. So to think that we can have our guys back in our home is, I think it'll be pretty emotional, to be honest, you know, for everybody involved. And We're just going to commit to it so much to give them something to shout about.
Well done, Steve. Thank you.
Thanks, Mitch.
Dab, you going?
Yeah. Thanks. Sorry, Steve. You mentioned there that you've been here before, touching on last year. Very different games, very different teams. What can you learn from last year's and apply to this time?
Yeah, we have. You know, we've been here. Like I said, we've been here before. And I think it'll be good to have a conversation with the players in the week, in the preparation, because that's what we do. We talk openly with the players and ask them what their views are, and maybe not just the ones who were with us last year, but people like Conor Hourihan, who have done it, you know, with previous clubs, Barnsley, ironically, as well. So it'll be and come up with what we think is the right plan. The difference is that we were obviously away last year, and this year we're home. Supporters are going to be in the stadium, so that comes into the mix as well. But and I think it'll be good to reflect on tonight, just having you know, a noisier stadium and people back in, even though it'll be obviously different for us on Saturday because we'll be home. So definitely something to think through and add into the plan for sure.
And you mentioned the emotion of Saturday as well. Is it quite a difficult balance to strike as a manager, like harnessing that emotion, but maybe not getting too emotional?
Yeah, 100%. You know, the biggest thing for us is to focus on what we're in control of, and that's recovering now, preparing, putting the plan together and getting ready to deliver on Saturday. And that's where our focus has to be. And of course, you know, there's bigger context behind that, what's at stake on the game, having supporters back. But, you know, if we really want to benefit from the day, we've got to focus on the job. And that's what, you know, my job is with the players to be able to do. So, like I said, you know, we enjoyed tonight, you know, even though we were in front of our own supporters. It was good to see people back in stadiums. But, you know, it's, without sounding like a playoff cliche, it's out of time, you know, and you know, we're going to stay calm and get ready for the next one.
Nice one. Thanks, Steve.
Thanks, Dav.
I haven't watched you in every single game, but you enjoyed that goal, didn't you, your celebration?
I enjoy every goal. I didn't enjoy it when I got a load of paint kicked all over my coat. I don't know if that was on camera.
Yeah, it was. I actually thought it was
great. Yeah, it cost me a few quid, that coat as well. But it's brilliant when you score a goal, isn't it? But, you know, I love Freddie's saves as well and love some of our defending. And, like I said, but, you know, we're all calm now. We're all relaxed and need to recover properly now and really get ready for Saturday because, you know, respect to Barnsley, we know what exactly who they are. They showed it again tonight. And, you know, we know what's coming and we've got to get ready.
Brilliant. Thanks, Steve.
Hi, Steve. Just there on tonight, concentration levels were at a premium there tonight. Barnsley put an awful lot of ball into the box in on top of sort of Freddie there as well. So throughout the 90 minutes, you kept your focus and your concentration, knowing what was coming. So that was a key to stand up to that sort of aerial sort of bombardment.
Yeah, and that's what I said before, Jim. It was like we knew what type of game it could look like at times. And you have to appreciate that, respect it, and deal with it. And I, concentration was a big part of that, and staying really committed to standing up to it. So, but we need to do it even better on Saturday for sure. We need to do it even more so on Saturday.
And Steve, just in relation to Saturday, are you going to try and break it up into maybe four quarters in terms of working through and getting the messages into the players in terms of trying to work through certain segments of the game?
No, not really. I think we'll stick to the plan of how we normally play and okay, there's different contexts around the game. Like I said before, you know, there's obviously a lot at stake and you know, for one team it's going to be the last game. So but, you know, we won't be splitting it into quarters. We'll just be dealing with it as it comes. Obviously, you know, start and end of halves are always important and things like that. But that's no different from any game, particularly in the league that we play in. So, you know, a good reflection now on tonight. You know, look at things we did well, but certainly be looking at the things we need to improve on as well. And trying to commit to that.
Let's look.
Thanks, Jim.
Steve, if I can just ask you, what do the next 4 days look like in terms of the preparation? Can you talk a little bit about that?
Normal, really. Schedule was done a while ago. We always plan in advance and we always stick to it. And it'll be just the normal process of recovering, training the boys who didn't play tonight, so they're ready to play if needed. And then meetings, you know, and all recovery types, and then back on the pitch all together, getting ready for Saturday. So nothing out of the norm. You know, there's no need for it. You know, you need to stick to the plan of how you prepare for games.
Cheers, Steve.
Thanks, Al.
Steve, can I just ask you, how did that paint get on your coat? How did it happen?
I think I can't remember which Barnsley player it was, but he was doing that simple. you know, that normal thing of trying to keep the ball in play. And as he kicked it, his boot must have hit the line. So,
oh, no.
No fool on me. And I got a bit of stick off the staff as well, but there you go.
Yeah, was it, how new was the coat?
You are, sorry.
How new was the coat?
Yeah, well, I'm going to get it cleaned up.
Oh, mate. Just a final one about Freddie, actually. I mean, we've talked about Andre on one side of the pitch, but he made two outstanding saves, and just his all-round game was brilliant. Actually, he made a couple of good saves here before, so this is a bit of a lucky hunting ground for him. But just tell us a little bit about Freddie and why he's been so phenomenal this season for you.
Well, I think first and foremost, all he'll be focused on is keeping another clean sheet on Saturday. You know, he won't be standing still on his performance, that's for sure. But, you know, he did play well tonight. Did his job. You know, and you take a step back and ask what you want your goalkeeper to do. You want to keep the ball out of the net, and, you know, and he did that well tonight. But I thought his positional play was good and decision making with the ball was good. But no time to think too much about it. It's time to look forward, and you know, all his attention, like everybody else, will be on trying to keep another clean sheet on Saturday.
Brilliant. Best of luck, Steve.
Thanks, Justin. Thanks, mate.